fellow human. I'm Rose from happyandauthentic.com, and welcome to my new minimalist series. A while back, I made a video about minimalism and how it can help you be healthier and happier. It turns out that was the most popular video of my entire happiness series, so now I'm gonna dedicate an entire series to that. Today I'm gonna show you 18 items that I think every minimalist, and well, pretty much everybody, should have. Number one, a smartphone. Okay, so it's not a smartphone, it's a case, but it's a stand-in because I'm using my smartphone to record this. So the reason why this is a must-have minimalist item is because, okay, I'm putting it down because it's really shiny and reflective. It's because it's not just a phone anymore. Your smartphone is a camera, a GPS, an address book, a video player, a photo album, an e-reader, a computer, and every now and then it also makes phone calls. Depending on the types of apps that you have on your smartphone, it could do 101 different things, which means it can take the place of 101 different things. Calculators, voice recorders, calendars, translators, music players, it can do everything. Number two is the Twist charging station. Now, what I like about this nifty little thing is that you plug it in and then you can charge 5 different devices. So there's 4 USB outlets around it. And on this top one here, I don't know if you can see very well, you can plug in Apple chargers. And I use it for my MacBook. Now, this was probably created for travelers, which is the initial reason why I bought it. Because, well, you can twist it and it changes the kind of adapter that you can use. But it's also just great for charging your things at home. I mean, you just need to plug it into one outlet and then you can charge 5 things. That's great. What more do you want, people? Number 3 is this amazing bag right here. Now, if you're a longtime minimalist, you've probably already watched 1,000,001 videos of people recommending this bag. It is the Tom Bin Synapse 19-liter backpack. And I love this thing. Honestly, I initially thought that maybe it was a bit overpriced and maybe people were overreacting. But once I got it, they were all proved to be right. They're not overreacting, folks. This is the best bag for a minimalist traveler. And even if you're not a traveler, I mean, it's just very well organized. I'm gonna make a more detailed video review of this backpack if any of you are interested. Let me know in the comments below. But for now, let me just say, it fits way more than it looks like it should. This is a quality backpack that will last the test of time and it will take whatever you throw at it. Trust me, I backpacked around Europe for 3 months with nothing but the contents of this bag. The way it's organized, the way everything inside of it is just spaced out, it is perfect. Trust me, just take my word on this one. Or if you don't want to take my word on it, subscribe and in a few more weeks, you can watch my video review on it. Once that video is ready, I'll make sure I put it up here so you can click on it. The next thing on my list is Zero shoes. Now, if you haven't heard about these shoes already, they're minimalist shoes because they're lightweight. I reckon this is probably 3 ounces. They've got a very, very thin sole. So when you're wearing them, you can still sort of feel the ground underneath without feeling, you know, if it's really hot, you're not gonna get burnt or, you know, you won't get scratched. Things like that. They've got zero drop at the heel. I mean, I know it looks like they've got one, but that's just like a heel cover so that your foot won't slip out. And they are super flexible. Like I can turn these into a little ball and they bounce right back out. You can't really ruin them. They're super sturdy as well. Like I've hiked in these and there was no issue whatsoever. They do also make a closed version for like running shoes, and they're exactly the same. They're super flexible like the other ones are. They're pretty much waterproof. I mean, they've got this material that I put an extra waterproof spray on them and they were fine, but everything around it is completely waterproof. And they're just as lightweight. They're super, super comfortable. And what I really love about these is they're way wider at the toe than most shoes are, so your feet really feel like they've got some room in there and they don't feel squished. These are another thing that I'm going to make a more extensive video on some other day. If you're interested, let me know in the comments or like this video and make sure to subscribe so that you don't miss it. Now, number 5. This one's a doozy.
Oh, shit, this thing's heavy.
Okay, bear with me. I know it looks too big to be a minimalist must-have, but this thing will completely declutter your kitchen. So this one thing here is called the Breville Fast Slow Cooker. And what it can do is, I'm just gonna read them out. Saute, sear, slow cook, pressure cook, steam, warm. And because it's got this handy little handle thing, and you can unplug it from the source, you can take it with you places. So if I'm going to a dinner party and I've cooked, like a vegan chili, I'm gonna just leave it in here once it's done and take the whole thing with me. It keeps it warm, it's easy to serve out of. I also use this to cook rice and it does a way better job than a rice cooker does, trust me. Number 6 is a bandana. Ta-da! Now I like these because you can use it for any number of things. You can use it as a washcloth, you can use it as a sweatband, a dish rag, a napkin, a hanky, hair cover, ice pack, lens cleaner. And sometimes I even use it as a little baggie to put my lunch into when I'm going to work. So pretend this is my lunch. Pop it in. Basically, you just make 2 knots. So you knot the opposite corners once, and then you knot the other opposite corners another time. And you've got this cute little packet that you can take with you. And then maybe use it to clean up after yourself once you're done. Now, the thing that was standing in as my imaginary lunch is my travel towel, which is number 7 on the list. So I know it looks really small and it couldn't possibly have a towel in there, but it packs super, super compact. So pull the thing out. There we go. A whole towel. It doesn't even fit in the screen. Ooh. It's microfiber, so it absorbs super, super well. It dries faster than you can just click your fingers. And it only weighs like a tiny little amount. I think the extra large one weighs something like 175 grams, but this one's just the medium, so this one's half that. Now, I got the small version because I'm tiny and I can get away with it. I don't need a lot of towel to cover me up, but you know, a bigger person's probably gonna need the extra large. Let's not kid ourselves. Now, just like the bandana, these things can be super useful. You can use it as a regular towel. Sometimes I'll also take it to the beach as a beach towel. But you can also use it as a picnic rug or a sarong, especially because these ones come with this little hook and a little button. So you can tie it around yourself and then hook it up. It's really quite convenient, I suppose. Number 8 is my amazing buff. Now, I know this just looks like another little hanky, but it's actually, you know, I don't know what you'd call this, tubular. So you can use this as any number of things. I think they can turn it into like 13 different things. You can use it as a neck warmer. You can use it to cover your face if you're in a Muslim country. Say you're traveling and you're not supposed to show your hair, this works just fine for that. I mean, obviously I'd have to also change what I'm wearing, but anyway, you get the point. You can use it as a beanie. Basically, you just twist it, turn it over on top of itself, and then use one side of it as a beanie, like that. I mean, you'd use it the other way around so that the colors are showing, but you get the point. You can also use it as, here we go, a bandana for your hair. Or you can pop it over your head like this. I mean, there's a whole bunch of different ways you can wear it. It comes with a bunch of instructions, or you can just look them up on YouTube. Point is, it's super useful, and if you get the UV one, it actually works kind of like a hat as well. If you've got really long hair, you can also use it as a scrunchie, but mine's really not long enough. I guess I can, I mean, it sort of does, but it would work better if I had longer hair. Anyway, the world is your oyster with this one. Number 9 is the Platypus water bottle. Now, this one's the platypus plus bottle, I think. And even though it's see-through, I'm going to try and help you see what it looks like. So it's got this little hook so that you can kind of attach it to things. And it's got these little pop tops. What do you call them? Oh, it's really hard to open though. So yeah, it kind of pops open and then pop it closed again. Basically, what I like about this is you can fold it really super small and compact, and it doesn't weigh barely anything. Say when you're not using it, you're on an airplane or whatever, you just pop it in your bag like that and doesn't take up any space. But then when you fill it up, whoop, slippery, it looks like this, like a regular 1 liter bottle. Well, I got it here. Gotta hydrate. Number 10 is Leatherman multi-tool with pliers. This particular model is the Sidekick, and I really like how sturdy it is. It's got this handy little clip here so you can pop it on your clothes, and I don't remember how many things it has on it. Let's have a look. One, the pliers. So we've got two screwdrivers, a Phillips head, and I don't know what that is, just a flathead screwdriver. A serrated knife. Quite a nifty thing. Right here we have a little ruler with a smaller flathead screwdriver on the edge and a file on the back. This here is a bottle opener slash can opener. On the inside of it right there, I don't know if you can see. There. You also have an emergency belt cutter. And whatever this little round thing is, which I am not sure, like I have no idea what that is. Pop a comment below if you know, because that would be helpful. I don't really find that I need any more tools than this, but you know, every now and then you need a hammer or a saw or the things like that, which I obviously have in my toolbox, or rather my boyfriend's toolbox. But yeah, this basically does the job, and sometimes I've even actually used it as a hammer or just kind of banging on things. Plus, it comes with this handy little case, and the carabiner is also a little multi-tool. So yeah, that's nifty. One of the things that I don't actually have that is on my list is something that I thought was really useful when I first started my minimalist journey, but then I kind of phased it out because I didn't need it anymore. I'm adding it in here because I do think it's very useful for some people, so yeah. The item is Dr. Bronner's liquid Castile soap. I'll pop a picture of it up here so that you kind of have an idea of what it looks like. They obviously have a bunch of different colors depending on what scent they have, but yeah, they basically look the same. And they come in a whole bunch of different sizes. You can get them in tiny little bottles like that, or you can get them in these like 2 gallon jugs, which I would actually recommend more than buying the little ones because obviously they're more cost effective. And you can use them for everything. I mean, Dr. Bronner's actually markets their soap as an 18-in-1, but I found that there's more than 18 uses for it. Let me quickly list off the uses they say on their website. Use it as a face cleaner, a body wash, a shampoo, bath liquid, shaving liquid, toothpaste, decongestant steam. I'm gonna guess that's only for their peppermint scented one, but I don't know, I'll leave you to decide. You can use it as a foot bath. Dishwashing liquid, I like that use. Laundry detergent, also something that I would use it for. Mopping liquid, multi-purpose cleaning spray, window cleaner, toilet cleaner, fruit and vegetable rinse, dog shampoo, plant spray, and bug spray. Now I would also add multi-purpose cleaner in the sense that you can use this to clean anything from your bathroom to your oven. Once I even used it to wash my car, and it worked perfectly. This is a vegetable oil based soap, so it doesn't use any animal products. It's completely vegan and doesn't do any animal testing. It's also eco-friendly and certified organic. Not to mention fair trade. They don't use any detergents or foaming agents, and they're packaged using recycled materials. So yeah, they're like the perfect soap if you're going to buy soap. Number 12 is Pyrex Tupperware. These are from a company called Decor. I think that they're an Australian company. So I don't know if you guys in America or Europe can actually get these, but I'm sure you'll get some other brand that does the same thing. Basically, they're multi-purpose, multi-use. So you can put your food in there and take it to work. They are microwave safe, freezer safe, oven safe, so you can cook in them, wait until they're cool, put them straight in the freezer, and then take them out of the freezer so that you can take them to work and microwave them. And they come in a whole bunch of different sizes. Like, I have the massive cooking size, which is wet at the moment because I just took it out of my freezer. The things I do for YouTube. I insist on getting glass containers because they last longer and they are better for the environment. Plus, they're better for your health. You don't have to worry about BPAs or anything weird like that leaching into your food. It's just, yeah, easier to clean as well. So what more do you want? And they will save you money. I mean, that's the main reason why I bought them initially, because I only need a couple of them and then that's it. I don't have to worry about it for the next however many years unless I break it. Now, something that usually gets a bad rap is sporks. I'm going to recommend this spork by Light My Fire, though, because this is completely different to any other spork I've ever used. Usually, sporks kind of look like this. They have the weird-ass tiny fork at the end that kind of ruins the spoon and makes it leaky, and it also doesn't really work that well as a fork either. It's just kind of a mediocre thing that doesn't work amazing. But this is a fantastic little thing to take to work or camping or traveling or anywhere. It's got the little serrated knife edge on the edge of the fork part. The fork is actually like a decent, very pointy. You can actually like stab things with it. And the spoon is a decent spoon. It's deep and you can actually use it to eat things that are liquidy like soup and stuff. So yeah, they also make a titanium version of this if you're not a fan of plastic, but I wanted it to be green. Just don't try to slice a tomato with it. Trust me, it's not gonna end well. But it's BPA free, so there's that. Number 14 is an epilator, or rather an epilator slash shaver slash trimmer, because I mean, that's what this is. A Braun Silk Peel 7, and they've upgraded heaps of times since I bought this. This is like 3 years old. So they come with a bunch of different heads and attachments. You can pop this epilator attachment off and put the shaving attachment on it. Ta-da! And now you can shave. And the shaver also comes with like a little trimmer head so that you can change how big you want your hairs to be. I mean, I don't know. It's rechargeable. It's waterproof. You can use it wet or dry. And you can get these in men's versions as well, so you can use it to shave your intimate man areas, or you can use it to shave your head, or your chest, or I don't know, whatever it is that men shave. Oh yeah, their face! Basically, the reason why I like this thing is you don't have to buy a bunch of disposable razors every couple of weeks. It doesn't dull, it's easy to maintain, it's rechargeable, so once you've bought it, that's it. You don't have to worry about it as long as you maintain it properly. Number 15, Teflon baking paper. If you have no idea what Teflon is, don't worry, it doesn't matter. I didn't really know what it was either. I had to literally look it up so that I could tell you what it is for this video. They're like $5, so they're cheap as chips. They cost about as much as it would to buy a whole roll of baking paper. Only this you can keep for as long as you want. You can cut it to size if it's too big. It helps you to use less oil. You don't have to buy baking paper all the time, which is really bad for the environment and your pocket. It's infinitely reusable, it's non-stick, and it can withstand up to 250 degrees Celsius or 480 Fahrenheit, if I have calculated that correctly. You can also get silicone ones, but I didn't like those because they were a bit thicker and harder to store than this is. 16. A similar item to the Teflon baking paper is silicone cling wrap. So anyway, this is what it looks like when it's not stuck to its little screen thing. And it's very sticky. You can use it to cover a sandwich, so use it as a food wrap, or you can put it on top of your plates or bowls or whatever, just like cling wrap. only better because you can wash this and reuse it. Now, this is from a company called Agrina, and I think they call it a two-in-one wrap because they say that you can use it to bake with, but I haven't really had much luck with that. I find that once you use it to bake with, it's a little more fragile, which is why this particular one had a rip in it. I used it to bake with instead of this, and it didn't like it. So I'm just going to use this as cling wrap from now on. What I found that is really cool about these, other than the fact that they come in different sizes, is you can use them to wrap food items that you've cut so they can last longer. So say you've cut an avocado. Everyone knows how annoying it is to cut an avocado and then come back the next day and it's all gross and brown. So I wrap it with this. And I don't have to worry about brown avocado. My life is complete. This one's not gonna need much explaining. Duct tape. Enough said. You can use this for anything. Last, but most certainly not least. This one's only for the ladies. Sorry, boys. A diva cup. It's just a menstrual cup. This is what it looks like. It's made out of silicone and it can contain about 15 milliliters of blood, which usually means you only have to empty it out once a day rather than having to worry about changing a tampon or a sanitary pad every couple hours. And it will last years and years. I mean, some companies say that their products can last 10 to 20 years if taken care of properly. So it may seem like they cost a lot of money up front, but they will save you heaps of money in the long run. The main reason why I got this though is not because it's convenient and not because it's cheap, but because it's healthier. I'm sure you know by now that tampons and sanitary pads are toxic. They're made of bleached rayon, cotton, and plastics. They can leave behind fibers that can cause bladder and vaginal infections, not to mention cause toxic shock syndrome, which menstrual cups do not cause. You can leave these in all night, no problem whatsoever. And some companies even make a version that you can use while having sex. That one's called a soft cup. And while tampons absorb your natural fluids that your vagina makes to keep itself clean and to keep the bacteria healthy, menstrual cups do no such thing. Plus, it allows your vagina to breathe naturally because it doesn't have all that suffocating plastic like sanitary pads do to like block the airflow. Another thing you need to remember is that sanitary pads and tampons are bleached using chlorine, which can produce dioxin that's a chemical linked to breast cancer, endometriosis, immune system suppression, and a whole bunch of other terrible ailments. The biggest surprise that I had when I started using this little fella is that my periods became shorter and way less painful. I mean, there's so many pros and like no cons to this. I am horrified that people don't tell their girls about this sooner. If I had started with this straight away and not had to worry about tampons and sanitary pads, not only would I have saved myself countless hours worth of shame, embarrassment, and yeast infections, TMI, but also a heap of money. So there you have it. The 18 items I think are must-haves for any minimalist and really for any person ever. Let me know in the comments below which one you think I should make a more detailed video on, or if there's any minimalist must-have items that you think I missed. I'll put a link down below in the description to every single item that I talked about in this video, and full disclosure, some of them do contain affiliate links, which means if you click on them and buy from that link, I will get a tiny kickback. It just keeps the channel going and shows me that you support me. Anyway, if you're new to minimalism or to my channel, make sure to subscribe and to click on the little notification bell so that you'll be one of the first people to get next week's video about the 10 things that I think you don't really need and you can get rid of. See you when I see you. Happiness is as simple as deciding you want it and then taking the steps to make it happen. This series was meant as a guide for